So you need to do a Z-Wave OTA update and you're not quite sure how to do it. In this video, I'm going to cover the most reliable way to perform the Z-Wave over-the-air update, as well as provide a few hints along the way. Stay tuned. Hey, smart homers, John Stone, the DIY smart home guy. Today we're going to go step by step through the instructions for updating your Z-Wave over-the-air or OTA capable devices. So let's get into it. This video assumes that your smart home hub is not capable of performing that OTA update function. At the time I made this video, OTA is not available on WinkHub, WinkHub 2, Hubitat Elevation C5, and earlier, SmartThings, and the Vera lineup, including Vera Edge, Vera Plus, and the Vera Secure. Now it's worth mentioning that the Vera line may, in certain circumstances, support the OTA updates, but these are pushed directly by Vera upon request from the device manufacturer. According to my information, Vera will not push updates upon the request of an individual customer. If you're a Vera user and you need to do an OTA update, you're gonna need to do it manually like the rest of us. It should also be mentioned that the OTA is in its very early stages and there aren't many devices out there that support it. You really only should be attempting this if you received a Verify OTA firmware file directly from the device manufacturer and you're sure that these devices support OTA updates. So, assuming that you have all these at your disposal, here's how you do the OTA update. The first thing that you'll need is a USB Z-Wave stick that is version 5 or newer. These include the AOTech Z-Stick Gen 5 Z-Wave Plus USB, Go Control HUSB-ZB-1 USB Stick Hub, which may also be branded as the Nortec, and the Zoo Z-Wave Plus S2 USB Stick ZST-10. There are also links to each of these in the description below. And since you're headed down that way anyway, go ahead and click that subscribe button and spank that bell icon to be notified of future videos and future live broadcasts.
This video is not paid endorsement and I receive no compensation for making this video. All product links in the description below are affiliate links and I may receive commissions if you purchase products from these links. Some products shown in the video were provided to me for free from the manufacturer. However, the video should not be considered an endorsement for any of these products.
For today's demonstration, I'll be using the Zoo's Z-Wave Plus S2 USB stick and updating a Zoo's Zen 26 Z-Wave Plus S2 in-wall smart switch. It's worth noting that you probably don't need to do a firmware update unless there's a known problem with your device or there's new functionality that you just can't live without. In other words, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. You're about to monkey around with the heart of your device. One wrong move could brick your unit. And then what do you got? A brick! And the only thing you can do with a brick is throw it up in the air. In my situation, I use the Zen 26 to control my front porch lights, but that same circuit also provides power to my Ring floodlight cam. Also, my porch lights themselves are Zigbee and controlled by an outdoor motion sensor, so I really don't want anybody accidentally turning off that switch. The latest version of the Zoo's S2 firmware for that Zen 26, by that I mean version 2.02 or newer, provides a capability to ignore manual on and off from the switch, and if I use this feature, I can use the switch button press events and the double tap events to control specific aspects of the lighting, and I don't have to worry that my camera's accidentally shut off. It also allows me to use my hub to cut power to the circuit in the event I need to do so, which I definitely need to do sometimes, so I really need to do this update. Really, I'm not just doing this because it's fun. Once you have your Z-Wave USB stick, you'll need software that allows you to perform the OTA update. I'm using an app called Z-Wave PC Controller. There's a link below. Please be warned that the link is a direct download of a zip file. You may have antivirus or security settings that prevent this from downloading, so you're going to want to be careful of that. There's also a link to a page published by Zoo's with a link to the latest software in the event mine has failed for some unknown reason. Once you get the Z-Wave PC controller software installed, make sure the software is up and running, then insert the Z-Wave stick. Go up to the gear icon and make sure that the software sees the stick. Depending on your PC, the COM port may be different than what I'm showing here, but you should see a USB serial device. If it's there, you're in good shape. If you don't see the Z-Wave USB stick, click the detect and the refresh buttons. This should bring it in. If it still doesn't see it, then you might need to reach out to the Z-Wave USB stick manufacturer and see if there's a PC device driver that's required. Now, you're going to need to go get that device that you want to get updated. You're also going to need to exclude it from your home automation hub. This is required so that you can include it into the Z-Wave stick so that you can perform the update that you just can't seem to live without. So a great question at this point is, can't you just include the Z-Wave stick into your hub and then perform the update and not worry about all this excluding and including junk? I mean, come on, that would sure save a lot of hassle. Well, I tried this both on SmartThings and on Hubitat, and I did run into a few problems. I'm not saying you're going to run into these problems, I'm just saying that I ran into these problems. So I'm going to give you a way that doesn't do that, but you're free to try it. Now, if you're hell-bent on getting this thing into your existing hub and trying it that way, here's what you're going to do. You're going to click down here on Network Management. You're going to put your hub into inclusion mode or discover devices or whatever it is. And then you're going to come down here and you are going to click on this learning mode. That's going to put the device into the Z-Wave stick into pairing mode, and it should allow it to include into your hub. And then everything else should work exactly as I describe it from here on out. So when I tried this method, the updates worked just fine, but the hub wouldn't recognize the new firmware. In the end, I had to exclude it and include the device anyway, just to get the hub to recognize the new firmware. Now I confess, it's very possible that I was doing something wrong, and if you know the dirty little secret, please leave it in a comment and I'll either make an updated video or I will put it on my website, which is DIYSmartHomeGuide.com. As an important piece of advice, you're going to want to take note of all of your scenes, groups, and automations used by the device you plan to update. For Hubitat users, this is simply taking notes or a screenshot of your device list. Vera users also have that same luxury. On SmartThings, you can get this through the Graph API web portal. Wink users, I'm not really sure how to do this or if it's even possible. After you've taken all of your notes, you're going to need to exclude the device from your smart home hub. After the exclusion is complete, let's get back to that PC software. Go into Network Management and click the Add button. You'll have the usual 60 seconds to get the device into inclusion mode. It may take a little bit of time, but it will add. You may see pop-up messages specific to your device. If you need help understanding these messages, I suggest that you contact the device manufacturer with regard to those messages. I mean, come on, they gave you the firmware file after all. They're probably the best equipped to know what to do. I'm trying to tell you, I probably can't help you. Now, once the inclusion is complete, you will see the success message at the bottom of the screen. You can confirm the add by looking at the device on the device list. And now we are ready for the update. Go to the OTA Firmware Update tab in the PC software by clicking on this little up arrow button. Scroll to select your targeted device, then confirm that your device is OTA capable. We're going to make sure that the Git button is blue. If it's not blue, return to the Git version button on the Network Management tab. If it's still not blue after you do the Git version, contact the device manufacturer and see what gives. And if that Git button is blue, the file folder icon should also be blue. Press the File Folder button to navigate to the folder with the firmware file that you want to put in place. If you have several versions of the firmware on your local PC, check and double check to make sure that you are grabbing the correct file. Once you've selected your file, click the Update button and you are off and running. While the update's running, you should be seeing status changes at the bottom of the screen. You will watch eagerly as each packet gets uploaded compared to the total number of packets expected to be included. And don't do anything, I mean anything, with your switch or the software until the update is finished. This could take about 8 to 10 minutes, at least it did for me, so be patient. Once you see this status successfully message, you're done. Now, one more time, let's go back to that network management page and use the basic set on and basic set off buttons to confirm the operation of the switch. If everything is running good, it's time to return the device to the hub. And once you've got everything done, you're just going to click that remove button and perform that same device exclusion-y thing that we just did. We might have done it a couple of times. And remember, that exclusion process must be completed within 30 seconds. So exclude it from that Z-Wave stick, and we're going to put it back in the hub. Here we go. And now that it's out of that Z-Wave stick, we're going to put it back in our hub, and we're going to check to make sure that it's doing what you want. In my case, I can now see the option for disabling manual control. It is available. I'm about to make a video where I use this capability in detail, so be sure to check that out. Now, if none of that worked, I can only suggest a couple of tips. Number one, rerun the steps and see if the second time's the charm. Number two, if it's still acting up, do a full factory reset on the device and try it again. Number three, if the device still won't take the update or it starts misbehaving after you've done the update, this is a good time to contact customer support for that device and see if they can help you out. I actually had one unit that I tried to update and it had problems, but I'm pleased to say that working with the manufacturer, we got everything squared away. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to click like. Over here, there's a couple of videos that I picked out just for you. Until next time, cheers.
Puppies. I like puppies.